Hello viewers, how are you all? So I'm back with a new video. This is the fourth video based on IoT. So I'll move a bit this side. So now today's video is based on the IoT architecture. That is the fourth video based on the IoT. Now I have a small request for you guys. Now since it's been a long time, I've been uploading videos. So I've been always telling you to subscribe and hit the bell icon and also comment. That you guys do obviously, but at the first of this video, I'm saying that if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and also just smash that bell icon so that whenever I upload new videos like this, you get the recent notifications. And also if you like these videos, like this kind of video tutorials based on IoT and blockchain is also coming in the future, so if you want all those kinds of videos, please give a thumbs up and please do not forget to subscribe and share. Thank you. So let's begin. So we have this IoT architecture. So we have this block diagram of this IoT architecture in this. So the first part consists of this entire, that is the two blocks we have in this circle. So the very first one is the peripheral hardware. So in this hardware, we have basically the sensors, the actuators and the drivers, which are necessary for driving all these small parts which are there inside this IoT devices. So going first to sensors, we have the sensors for taking input from the environment. Like we have seen in AI, how robotic agent accepts inputs from the sensors, from the external environment. Then we have the actuators for actually carrying out that particular action in response to that particular sense, which is interpreted from the external environment. And then we have drivers, which is used for driving that particular kind of activity. Now this is linked with the embedded system. Now this embedded system is there inside the IoT device. Like we have different types of communication protocols in this. We have the Wi-Fi technology, that is the wireless fidelity. We have the Bluetooth over small range distances. Then we have the Ethernet. Then we have Zigbee protocol, which is also used for short distance communication, short distance what you can say internet transfer. Then you have the ISDL, that is the inter-site data link. It is the inter-site data link, which is also a wireless communication protocol used for in communicating with the IoT. Then you have the IPv6, that is the Internet Protocol version 6 addressing schemes for all the subnet mask and the IP assignment. That I will explain why we have the use the IPv6 addressing schemes in IoT and not the IPv4. Then you have the connection services in this. This can be n number of things. Like we have the all the storage mechanisms and all the connection services are included in this. So this all sums to the embedded systems, and these two are linked in between for a connectivity. Then we have at this side, we have the local connectivity. So this is the interconnectivity and this is the local connectivity. With local connectivity, we have access to the outside local networks. That is, we have access to local area network, we have access to wide area network, and then we have access to MANET. MANET is mobile ad hoc networks, that is for mobile hotspots and all, for tethering services and all. Then you have a connectivity to the internet by means of a web API. Similarly, this web API is employed for this as well, that is connection of peripheral services and embedded systems. And then we have the other devices, like we have n number of IoT devices which will be coming in the future. So everything is connected by means of web API or some other kind of API to the internet. So this is the block diagram in fact for the IoT architecture. Then I've said that IPv6 addressing scheme is employed in this, and why not IPv4? So there is a short note on this. So now you know that IoT devices require n number of different devices to communicate. So different devices in this must be uniquely discovered. So obviously there are n number of devices in this universe, and if IoT wants to identify them, they should be uniquely identified or uniquely discovered. For this unique discovery, you need to assign unique IP addresses for this. Okay, that's fine. So now as the number of IoT devices online is expected to surpass 20 billion in the further future years by 2020 mark. That is the threshold. And if you deploy IPv4 addressing in this, it can only support up to 4 billion. So if you use IPv4 addressing scheme in this and then you want to support 20 billion, that's not possible. So for that, we use the IPv6 addressing scheme and also unique address. IoT devices essentially have IPv6 addressing schemes in this. So all these devices have either fixed or that is subnet mask IP address of the type version 6. Now unique IP address makes IoT devices discoverable in the internet as independent tools. This is the most important concept to keep in mind to understand the IoT. Since IoT requires to identify n number of other devices which are unique, which has unique MAC address, which has unique IP addresses, you need to deploy IPv4 addressing scheme in this for IoT architecture or to discover new devices which are there or which are there keeping coming up every new day. So that's all for today. We'll wind up. So if you found that you got educated by watching this video, like I said in the beginning of this video, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and also smash that bell icon so that whenever I upload any video like this, you get the recent notifications. And also do comment below for more videos. Now I have a short announcement for you that I have published a book on this, that is the structured programming approach. This is for the Mumbai University for the second year students. This book is written by me itself, and one peculiarity of this book is you have this diagrams, as you can see, it is hand drawn by me so that student get a friendly interface for drawing these diagrams. And also many block diagrams and also other steps are included in this. So you have Viva questions as well as university questions at the end of this book. So if you want this video, if you like this book, or if you want to purchase this book, I will put the link in the description or the show notes below so that you can buy this book. And thanks for watching my